back. This is the property show. Now, one of the hottest property markets of the National Capital Region or NCR is Dwarka Expressway. But the delay in the construction of this alternate link road between Delhi and Gurgaon owing to legal issues has subdued some of the excitement for this market. Next year is going to be a big year for this market as 14 new projects will be up for delivery. But is the area worth living in? The property show traveled down this broken highway to find out how Dwarka Expressway scores on the livability scale.
Bold letters on this blue board welcome you to Dwarka Expressway, and a row of these ads hung on poles declare that now is the right time to invest here. But the only glitch in this property market is the yet to be completed Dwarka Expressway or the Northern Peripheral Road, which has been stuck for years. Pegged as one of the biggest infrastructure projects between Delhi and Haryana, Dwarka Expressway fails to walk the talk.
रहने के लिए तो मैम अभी काफी सारी सुविधा मिलनी है, कोई सुविधा नहीं है। रोड सबसे मेन तो रीड रोड है, रोड पे कोई काम नहीं हो रखा है। और इन्वेस्टर के सारा का सारा जो भी पैसा लगा है इन्वेस्टर का लगा हुआ है, एंड यूजर का किसी का पैसा नहीं लगा हुआ है यहाँ पे। ना तो कोई स्कूल है, ना कोई शॉपिंग कॉम्प्लेक्स है, ना रोड की सुविधा है, ना सीवर वगैरह डले हुए हैं। अभी सारा काम ऐसे ही डिले पड़ा है।
The 18-kilometer long Dwarka Expressway is partially complete. 14 kilometers of the built highway is punctuated with 4 kilometers of dust and beaten tracks or even villages at 4 different places. These blue poles are the only sign that say that the expressway will continue down this length, but when? That's uncertain. Partial possession has already been given in Raheja Atharva in Sector 109 this year. By the end of 2015, a total of 4,553 units will be up for possession in 14 projects. But there are no schools or hospitals to cater to the needs of those who might want to live here. Every basic need, they will have to depend either on Palam Vihar or to the other established sectors of Gurgaon.
It has a good support of the existing city and also Ansal Palam Vihar, which is in the vicinity. So Ansal Palam Vihar and the amenities inside Ansal Palam Vihar, which are pretty well developed in terms of hospitals, schools, malls, which are required for your daily needs, are already existing and running very well. The only thing is, once the road comes up, it will be business as usual for all the developers.
There seems to be a ray of hope for the real estate companies with business interests in this area, with repeated assurances from central government and various other agencies.
Good news is that the past few interactions with all people of authority in the government, the civic authorities, whether it's the Delhi authorities, the Gurgaon, Hooda, and people like that, even ministers, have been quite forthright in saying that we know this used to be a pain and we know the expectations of the people over here and we will not let you down. And in fact, I've even heard that within next 3 months there's going to be a positive action to make sure that the expressway is, you know, up and running and people can, you know, start living in that place with great comfort and ease.
This is the place where the Dwarka Expressway will join NH8 highway. But the battered board and the untouched land tell some very different story.
Dwarka Expressway is the most ambitious project undertaken by the Haryana government under Gurgaon Master Plan 2021. But the ambition does not seem to be turning into reality. The developers might be ready to deliver on their promises. The government certainly is not. From Dwarka Expressway with camera person Pooja Arya, this is Anjali Istwal for NDTV.
Okay, we'll stay with Gurgaon. We have an email query by Sunil Piplani.